we're doing makeup that was designed for a mime today, and it was also designed to be performed in front of a black light. So there's a bit more accent on the whites. For starters, we have to get our eyebrows down. So going back to that glue that we talked about, we're going to get the eyebrows nice and flat, so that way they kind of disappear into the mix of what we're doing today. I scooped out just a little bit, so that way I am not double dipping into the glue, because again, same concept as before, we want to make sure that we're keeping that sanitary. I also preset my makeup onto an artist palette. Reason being, this allows me to keep my color separated, I can keep my brushes where they need to be, and I just keep that on the side in front of me, so that way it is readily available and divided, all based on what I need. I just use my finger. This set of makeup is designed to be either creepy or not creepy. I've got a couple of different versions of this type of makeup based on its context. The one that I'm demonstrating today, however, is going to be what we used for our Halloween show. So it's a little bit creepy. It's a cracked doll. So she came to life and shared her story. And so this one does not actually entail any eyeliner or any kind of mascara. We are going to completely white out the eyes, and we're actually going to draw on fake lashes and fake lines around our eyes to really make them pop. The lips on this are the same regardless. Again, I've done a couple of different lip options for dolls over the years, and I have another rendition that is a less creepy doll. You just use red instead of black, so you can swap out the colors. Quite ghostly looking, huh?